Hi, I'm Dr. Victor Dolan, your local doctor of chiropractic, and came across an interesting article on the internet on WebMD Health News. And this is about Clostridium difficile, a disease, a bacteria that's an epidemic right now, and it's spreading not just in hospitals where people acquire this disease, acquire this condition, but in doctor's offices, clinics, and other healthcare facilities. And this comes from a CDC study, the Centers for Disease Control. C. diff, short for Clostridium difficile, are spore-forming bacteria that cause diarrhea. Severe cases can result in life-threatening condition called toxic megacolon. There's an ongoing epidemic with a particularly nasty, especially toxic C. diff strain that's on the loose right now. C. diff kills about 14,000 Americans each year. Half of the infections are in people younger than age 65, but 90% of the deaths are in people 65 and over. Cases have tripled over the last decade. And this is the importance of this article. Why have cases tripled over the last decade? Traditionally, C. diff infections were thought to be mostly a problem for hospitals, but today's report shows that these infections are a patient safety concern in nursing homes and outpatient care settings as well. And this is from Alina Arias, a PhD, CDC Principal Deputy Director. There's been a lot of worry about C. diff spreading in the community, but the CDC study finds that nearly all C. diff infections, 94% of these infections, are linked to medical care. About 75% of C. diff infections first show up in people recently cared for in medical doctor's offices, clinics, or nursing homes. Who's at risk? C. diff spores can live on hard surfaces for months or longer. They get into the body when you touch a surface contaminated with the invisible spores and then touch your mouth. Stomach acids can't kill the spores, so they make their way deeper into your gut. C. diff usually doesn't infect healthy people. As with most bacteria and virus, as with most germs, it's opportunistic. The normal bacteria living in your gut won't let C. diff spores take root. But if you've recently taken antibiotics, that's a different story. Antibiotics destroy good bacteria that protect us from infection, leaving the door open for C. diff to take over. If people swallow C. diff spores during this time of vulnerability, they can become infected. And that comes from the medical doctor Clifford McDonald, again an expert from the Center for Disease Control. Your risk of C. diff infection goes up 7 to 10 times while you are taking antibiotics and for at least a month later. You're still at threefold higher risk the second and third month after you finish taking antibiotics. Apparently, it takes your body a while to recuperate, to repair from using antibiotics. Often, this risk is unnecessary. Nearly 50% of antibiotics are inappropriately prescribed, killing off the natural bacteria in our gut, says Jan Peterson, MD, president of the Society for Healthcare Epidemiology of America. And that was in a news release. Here's how it works. C. diff spreads according to this scenario by the Centers for Disease Control. You go to your medical physician's office and you get a prescription for an antibiotic. A month later, you break your leg and go to the hospital. A healthcare worker forgets to wear gloves while caring for a C. diff patient down the hall. You get a C. diff infection. 2 days later, you go to a rehab facility where you come down with diarrhea. You're not tested for C. diff. Your nurse doesn't know you are infected and doesn't wear gloves while she's treating you. Another patient gets infected. You finally get diagnosed with C. diff and properly treated, ironically, with more antibiotics. McDonald says, the medical doctor, that this constant interplay between different kinds of healthcare facilities keeps C. diff in circulation. Half of the cases diagnosed in hospitals are in patients already infected when admitted to the hospital. That means hospitals are partly at the mercy of surrounding facilities, including doctor's offices. because patients often transfer back and forth, an infection in one place can easily become a problem in another facility. This points to a strict need for prevention across all facilities. In a pilot project, 71 hospitals in Illinois, Massachusetts, and New York, with a catchment area of 111 acute care facilities and 300 nursing homes, corroborated to stop C. diff spread. Over 20 months, the hospitals were able to cut C. diff infections by 20%. The CDC's advice on what patients can do to stop the spread of Clostridium difficile. Antibiotics are life-saving medicines, but do much more harm than good when you don't need them. Don't beg your medical doctor for an antibiotic prescription if he or she doesn't think you need one. Take antibiotics as prescribed, and only as prescribed. Tell your doctor if you have been on antibiotics and get diarrhea within a few months of using that antibiotic. Wash your hands carefully and thoroughly after using the bathroom. If you have diarrhea, try to use a separate bathroom from the rest of the family. Be sure the bathroom is cleaned well if someone with diarrhea has used it. If you're a caretaker for a person with C. diff infection, wear gloves during active treatment, then clean your hands thoroughly. If the patient is using the bathroom, clean it well with a bleach solution or other approved spore-killing disinfectant. And this CDC study appears in the March 6th early release issue of MMWR. Just another note to be careful of the side effects of medication. Antibiotics cause this or contribute to this. Not washing your hands contribute to it. Very important to know about. Antibiotics are overprescribed and are contributing to this epidemic. Again, this is Dr. Victor Dolan wishing you good health, naturally.